Blessings upon blessings. This is J-Unity from Richmond, VA. Please stay tuned for season 7 of
Let's Talk to the Lord,
gospel radio talk show, created and hosted by Apostle John E. Ross. And we are J-U.
Trying to do what's right, but end up.
He leads me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. When you become a believer, your spirit is made right. But sometimes, the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hole in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister, Leandria, here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Deliver me, 'cause all I seem to do is hurt me, hurt me. Lord, deliver me. 'Cause all I see to do is hurt me.
Yes, sir.
Hurt me.
I know we should be finishing, but sing it for me 2 more times.
Lord, deliver me. 'Cause all
hurt you in the past won't control your future. Starting now, is a new day. This is your exodus. You are officially released. Now sing it for me, Leandria.
In the name of our Lord and Savior, Christ Jesus, I am your gospel radio apostle, Apostle John E. Ross, creator and host of this podcast, lead apostle and founder of the Omega International Prophetic Ministries, and thank you for tuning in for season 7 of the Let's Talk to the Lord gospel radio talk show. And Kingdom, our guest for this episode in Season 7 is Christian author Nia Nicole. Nia Nicole, welcome to Let's Talk to the Lord.
Good morning. Thank you. How are you today?
I am blessed and glad to have you here with us. And before we begin our interview, please share with the Kingdom your story of repentance and your journey to relationship with our Lord and Savior, Christ Jesus.
For my personal story, I was in high school, actually, and my sister... My sister went away to visit a college, so her car was available at the house. So during that time, I kind of did what I wanted to do, right? But in this moment, it was meant to be. So what I mean is it was in my spirit to go to church this particular day by myself, which had never happened before. So I went to church, and while I was sitting there, I couldn't believe that I was there by myself. But the foundation was laid out for me because the car was available. So when they called for people to join, it was as if somebody pulled me up, and I was found myself walking towards the front, and that's the day that that I got saved. Now, what was very unique for me is I had never spoken in tongue before, and they had us saying Jesus. They just had us saying the name Jesus repeatedly. And I automatically started speaking in tongues, and it shocked me, and I was just overwhelmed with emotion. I was crying, but I felt like I was literally floating for the rest of the day because that was such a natural high.
Amen.
And the other part, I'm sorry, my journey. So there are several different journeys that I've taken through my life that has made me closer to God. So when I was working on my undergrad degree, you know, God will ask you to do things and you don't understand it. But when it's in your spirit, you will not get rest until you do it. So I had a wonderful music collection, like a big garbage bag full of CDs of secular music. And God told me, throw it away. and just listen to gospel music. And I said, what? You know, my collection is awesome. So it was difficult, but I listened, and I did it. And that was a strength that I needed because I was a single parent working on my undergrad. So it was God that got me through that. But I had to listen. You have to listen and be obedient. If I may share another story, a recent one, actually. So I was, do I have time to share another one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I was getting my nails done, pedicure, manicure, and a part of the package was to get a neck massage. So the lady that had finished my pedicure kept trying to touch my purse. It's a leather purse, and she had oil on her hand, so I didn't want her to touch it. And I said, oh, I'll get it. And so she tried like two more times to touch my purse, and that final time, it wasn't nice. I said, don't touch my purse. And when I said it, like, it didn't feel right in my spirit, and I was like, oh, I shouldn't have said that. So I'm feeling bad while she's doing the neck massage, and I had to take off this necklace because I didn't want it to interfere. And I laid it across my lap, and I forgot that it was on my lap. So we moved to the little neck chair, and after it was done, I went back to the location where I had my pedicure, and I'm looking on the floor, looking in the chair, and I couldn't find this necklace. Now, this necklace is very sentimental because someone I've known since the seventh grade, we've been best friends since then, and she gave this to me, and it's engraved. So it was sentimental. I went back to that section literally three times, and my girlfriend that I was with, she helped me look as well. So I said, okay, well, I'm just going to have to let her know that I lost this necklace. And something, not something, the Holy Spirit said, repent right now. I said, God, I'm so sorry for, you know, my response to the lady that was trying to help me with my purse. And I was on my way out the door when I had given up. I reached out my hand, and I heard a voice say, here it is. And I had chills, and I was about to tear up. And I said, I knew that this was all God because of the way it happened. If I had not listened and repented in that moment, I wouldn't have got the necklace back. So it's things like that that you have to pay attention to, because when God says move or do something, you need to do it. So I could go on and on, but I'll stop right there.
Amen. And who is Nia Nicole now in the body of Christ and in the kingdom of God?
Well, I am a teacher, an author, a mom. I inspire others whenever I have the opportunity to. I like to pour into people. And that actually ties into my purpose, which is a program that I'll share with you a little later. But it all ties in, and it makes sense, and you'll understand as well when I share.
Amen. Kingdom, I will be interviewing Nia Nicole from a book authored by our guest titled Pressing Through to My Purpose. Kingdom, Pressing Through to My Purpose is a faith-based book about some of the missteps in life. Kingdom, our guest and author declares, have you ever put your trust in a man and been disappointed? Do you see a negative cycle in your personal life or at the workplace, or have you been trying to give your life to the best of your ability, live your life to the best of your ability without guidance from the Lord? If so, this book is a good book for you, because it shares the trials and tribulations in her life as a educator. To begin, Kingdom, when I researched the etymology of the word pressing, I learned it is a Middle English word from the Old French noun presse, and from the Latin verb press, meaning to keep pressing. In other words, don't give up. Kingdom, many times in life we prefer a easier road or not to have to work as hard to accomplish our goals. But unfortunately, it's not the norm for our lives to overcome, to achieve, to accomplish goals in life on a bit of ease. Most things in life take a little time and some work, meaning years in college or school, time to save, time to prepare. Likewise, in our character, to recreate our character like Christ is not always easy. I think that because of the words used in the fruit of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, etc., we think in our minds that it's easy to accomplish even that kind of a goal in our character, but it takes work and a lot of experience to accomplish that goal. Jesus, Yeshua, is the only flesh being that could embody all of those characteristics at the same time while walking in love, including while enduring the pain and agony of the cross of Calvary. Kingdom, pressing means to force, to take authority, and to impress as a soldier. Kingdom's Philippians, the 3rd chapter, and the 14th through the 16th verse declares in verse 14, I press on toward the goal to win the supreme and heavenly prize to which God in Christ Jesus is calling us upward. Verse 15, so let us who are spiritually mature and full grown have this mind and hold these convictions. And if in any respect you have a different attitude of mind, God will make that clear to you also. Verse 16, only let us hold true to what we have already attained, meaning in Christ, and walk and order our lives by that. Sister Nicole, according to your experience shared in your book, your walk with Christ, what are the first steps to pressing through to our purpose?
Well, my first steps, I had to be an olive. And what I mean is I had to be shaken, beaten, and pressed for my oil to flow. And I realized what my purpose was. So it stayed on my mind. It tugged at my heart. And I knew that it incorporated helping others and giving of myself. I really love our future leaders, and I feel like they need a good foundation. So I knew that my purpose was related to our future leaders, and that's why I had to go through the various experiences that I went through that I discussed in my book. But I wouldn't change it for anything because it's helped me, actually. It didn't break me down. Well, it did break me down, but with God, I bounced right back, and I'm stronger, and I'm ready to move forward with my purpose.
Amen. And Sister Nicole, what's your best advice to someone who can see a negative cycle in their personal life or at a workplace?
Well, it keeps repeating for a reason. What is God trying to reveal to you? There's a blessing in it that we're supposed to pay attention to. So I always like to say, stop focusing on what's going on around you and look up to God. Stop looking for others to build you up, give you what you need. God has the answer. So just continue to look up.
Amen. Sister Nicole, for those who are on a different path from you or I, how does your book and testimony help them begin to learn to lean on the Lord and do it the way God is asking?
Well, I'm very transparent in the book and in my personal life with my friends. I don't mind sharing my shaken, beaten, and pressed times because I know that that's what God used to lead my steps. What's important is to help those that come behind you. It's a lesson in everything wrong that may be happening. I mean, it could be you run out of gas and you're on the side of the road. Okay, yes, that's a bad thing that you're out of gas, but what is it preventing you from? You know, look at it like that. Find God in everything. And just overall, I'm a genuine person. So I think that people should just be genuine to who they are. Being genuine is inspiring. Be you. Find your path. Now, I understand that some people look to some social media stars or whatever to try to model behind, but are they transparent? Are they really showing and sharing what it took to get there? So it's okay to admire some things that they do, but don't try to do everything that they do. Be you. Be genuine.
Amen. Kingdom, the second chapter of 2 Timothy and the second verse declares, "And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also." Verse 3, that thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Verse 4, no man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. Verse 5, and if a man also strive for masteries, yet is he not crowned except he strive lawfully, meaning according to the gospel. So, Sister Nicole, what are some ways outlined in your book that can help that person that put their confidence in the human person rather than God and has been led astray and now has to begin again?
Mm-hmm. So, it's two key things that you need to keep in mind in those situations. You either need to move, as in shift, or remove yourself from that situation. So I'm going to refer to a story in the book when I look to a human for guidance. So it was my first teaching position, and the principal was a good principal on the outside. My sister attended her elementary school, and it was a very great school. So I thought I would be in good hands as far as leadership and learning the ropes of the classroom. However, when you work under this lady, you got to see the other side of her. So my first teaching position was in a Montessori environment, but we had to tie it to the Illinois standards, so we had to figure out how to merge that. My training and when I worked on my master's was in the traditional method. And I was thrown into this position, not thrown, I was blessed to get a position that was a Montessori, school. So the classrooms and the environment is supposed to be calm and quiet. But my class was not. It was a school that was just opening. It was three different classrooms. The other two classrooms understood the assignment. And my kids, they were age 3 to 6. They were loud. And I guess the principal had enough. So it was a couple of months that went by. And she called me to her office and she said, "Miss Nicole, if we were all sitting on a ledge, I would push you off." Right? So this is me having this faith in this human to lead me in a positive direction, but she did not. However, I did remove myself from that situation when I could, But I and the principal were so busy at looking at what was going on around, I didn't notice that it was a grandmother of one of my students that was very happy with the progress that she saw in her granddaughter. And she came to me after this principal said what she said. And she said, you know, she didn't know anything that went on. But she said, I love the progress that I see in my granddaughter. She loves coming to school. She loves your class. I appreciate you. If you ever need anything, let me know. And that's when she flipped me her card, and I realized later that she was a principal. So that door was available to me at the right time. And you'll see in the book, I couldn't go immediately to her school, but you'll find out why when you read the book. But it's just the fact that that blessing was there in the midst of that storm. So those are the types of things that I'm saying pay attention to when you're going through various things.
Amen. Sister Nicole, is there anything else that we have not covered during this podcast about pressing through to my purpose that you would like to share with the kingdom?
Absolutely. So my purpose is my nonprofit, We Build Up Incorporated. It teaches SEL, service learning projects, etiquette, exposure to culture and the arts for our future leaders. So the goal is to have K to 12. I'm going to start this in the fall for 6th to 8th graders. I'm going to start there. So the website is wbuleaders.org. You can go there to find out more information.
Amen. Kingdom, I pray this episode has shed some light for those who have discovered that we are all born with a purpose and a plan for our lives. And for all of us, the main idea is that we go to God and build a relationship with Him and allow God to choose our path. Nia Nicole, please introduce yourself to the kingdom.
Well, I am Nia Nicole, the author of Pressing Through to My Purpose. A portion of my book sales goes towards my nonprofit that I just mentioned. So you can follow me on Instagram, Nia_Nicole_2021, or Facebook, Nia Nicole. And you can also go to my website, and you can purchase the book. There's a link on there, and you can find out a little bit more about me. And my website is Nia Nicole. PTTMP.com. And for bookings, you can go to the website KGPR-LA.com. Or you can also contact me via Instagram or Facebook.
Amen. And how may the kingdom again support your ministry and purchase your books?
You can go to my website, Nia Nicole, PTTMP.com, and please spread the word.
Amen, amen, and amen again. Kingdom, Let's Talk to the Lord can be heard on Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Alexa, and YouTube. You may download episodes from Speaker.com, found under Let's Talk to the Lord. We are live every Wednesday at 6 p.m. Central Time from Kingdom Influencers Broadcast. com, and 11 a.m. every Saturday from SensationalSoundsRadio.net. Please write to us at letstalktothelord@yahoo.com. Please follow us on Twitter at Ross Apostle. Please visit our website, letstalktothelordradio.international. Please download our app on your Play Store for your cell phones under Let's Talk to the Lord Radio. You can now ask Alexa to play Let's Talk to the Lord Radio International and Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show. We are now on Roku. To find us on Roku, please search My Tuner Radio platform. When you get to the MyTuner Radio platform, you may find us under Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Station. If you would like to listen to the podcast on Roku, please search the iHeartRadio app on your Roku, and then you may find us under Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show. Kingdom, Let's Talk to the Lord Radio International is your 24-hour station for talk news, radio interviews, and Christian music. On Amazon, order our book, Spiritual Guidance Through Alzheimer's Disease, with author Kimberly V. Porter. All of my music are available on Amazon and all digital stores and outlets. Lord, Give Me Another Chance, featuring Sean E. Scales and Tamara Lloyd, and Remember Now Thy Creator, featuring King David the Vessel, a new duo and doctrine, is also available on all digital stores under the name Minister John E. Ross. So, Kingdom, until next time, may God bless you. And may God keep you living your lives at the foot of the cross under a open heaven. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen.